Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and in today's video I'm going to show you how to make buttercream stripes. And I'm going to start with my cake. It's already frosted and it's been in the fridge for about 20 minutes, and now I'm going to start using the comb. And I use it at about 45 degree angle between the cake and the comb, and I'm going to be doing the indentations very slowly. So to keep the side smooth, I'm going to use my scraper and I'm going to remove any excess of buttercream. You're going to notice that some of that buttercream is going to go into the indentations. So we're going to keep on using the comb. And as you are doing the indentations, you're going to realize that instead of using a 45 degree angle, you're going to have to do a 90 degree angle. And that is with the intention of making the indentations a little bit deeper, and that is going to help when we're removing some of the buttercream and revealing those straight lines. So I put my cake on the refrigerator for about 20 to 30 minutes, and that allows the buttercream to firm up and to it lets me to work a little bit faster and more precisely with the buttercream. Now I'm using the comb very often, but at the same time I'm scraping the excess buttercream. Now I am not applying a lot of pressure when I do this because I don't want to take some of the buttercream that I already applied to the cake and that I'm going to use at the end to reveal those color stripes. So at the end, to make sure that I got a 90 degree angle on those indentations, I had to run the comb on hot water and then coming the cake at 45 degrees, excuse me, and again running my scraper. And once again, just very softly do it again with a comb. But my recommendation is to put the cake on the fridge every time that you see that the buttercream is becoming like too soft and you're not getting the indentations perfectly done. Now I have my colored buttercream ready on my piping bag, and I'm using tip number 5. It's a round tip, and I'm just gonna start filling up those indentations. You can choose if you skip one of the rows or if you want to do it all the same color. It is up to you. This is where I really like it, because you can become very creative on what colors you're going to use to fill these gaps. So if you decide to skip a couple of rows like this ones, instead of doing orange, you can do black, or the base color that you're using for the cake, and there's gonna be like a big gap in between the lines. Just go back around the cake and fill out any little gaps that you might see. So now with a scraper, I'm gonna go around the cake and remove any excess of buttercream. And I know it's gonna look bad, but this is part of the process. It just looks like you just were smearing buttercream onto the cake, but it is part of the process. So just go ahead and fill out any gaps that you see at this point, and start removing the buttercream with the scraper. Like I said before, the pressure doesn't have to be that strong. Something you have to do every time you run the scraper around the cake is to clean your scraper completely with a napkin, and that's what I use, and it worked perfectly fine. But if you have to rinse the scraper, go ahead and rinse it, so it has to be like really clean so you don't smear the buttercream or the excess of buttercream again into the cake. So just go ahead and take a look around the cake and see if you're missing any spots, and this would be the perfect time to fill those little gaps and run the scraper again. Since I didn't find anything, I just went ahead and cleaned my board. And here goes the cake again into the fridge for about 20 to 30 minutes. Now that the time has passed, I'm gonna remove the excess on the top of the cake. And I'm using just a knife, it's a sharp knife. And all I have to do is run it around the top, removing the excess buttercream. My cake still chilled, and I'm just gonna pass my scraper once again, just to remove a little bit more of the buttercream and have more straight lines. I hope this video has been helpful. If you have any more questions, please put it on the comments or visit the website behindthecake.com, where you can find all the details and the tips that I use to decorate this cake. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up, share with your friends, and subscribe for more videos like this one. Thank you, and you all take care. Bye.